Let's try to solve cart pull V1 with the Ray RLlib library. And the first step is to initialize Ray. Ray is a package offering distributed computing primitives, and RLlib is built on Ray. To initialize Ray, we must first import it and then issue the command ray.init. The second step is to run an experiment to solve the reinforcement learning problem. And an experiment involves four things. Number one, a reinforcement learning environment, such as cart pull V1. Number two is a reinforcement learning algorithm to learn in that environment. We can use something like proximal policy optimization, or PPO in short. The third thing is the experiment configuration, which consists of algorithm configurations, environment configurations, and so on. And finally, an experiment runner, which is called tune within the Ray package. So to run the experiment, first import tune, the experiment runner. And then to run the experiment, just use the command tune.run. And as the first argument, provide the name of the algorithm, which is PPO. And you can look up the algorithms available from this link, which I'm going to share with you in the lecture notes. So you can see in this table the list of all available algorithms, and you can use any one of them. So we are using PPO. All right, so that's the first argument. And then you supply the configuration as a dictionary, and the environment is specified using the env key. And you can simply use the name of the environment if it is a gym environment, because RLlib has native support for gym and therefore knows all the environments in gym by name. The other configurations go here. And if you don't supply anything else, then the default configurations will be used. And the default configurations works in most problems. All right, so let's run that. And as you can see, RLlib happily starts using the PPO algorithm on the cart pull V1 environment. Cool, so while this experiment is running, let me tell you a few more things. So when running an experiment, RLlib decides on the experiment configuration in the following manner. It starts with the common configurations, which is in this web page, and I will put a link to that in the lecture notes. These are all the common configurations. Next, it looks at the algorithm-specific configuration, which you can find in the algorithms page that I showed you before. Just click on the algorithm that you are applying and then scroll down a little and you will find the algorithm specific configuration. The values set in this dictionary will override the ones that are set in the common configuration. And finally, the configuration that we specify here will be applied, and this will override the common and the algorithm specific configuration. The default configurations work quite well in many problems, so you don't need to understand the meanings of all these things over here. Next, let's look at what happens when we run an experiment. An experiment looks like this line. It has alternate training and evaluation phases. The training phase involves iterative policy improvement, as we discussed in an earlier lesson, and the evaluation phase tests how well the current policy is performing. This is a bit like the classic training and validation cycle in supervised learning. We can change the length of the training cycle by changing the configuration parameter evaluation interval. The length of the evaluation phase can be changed by changing the configuration parameter evaluation num episodes. So let's try to run the experiment again by setting different values for these parameters. So let's set evaluation interval to 2, meaning that 2 training iterations will be run between the evaluations. So this is the number of training iterations between evaluations. And let's set the evaluation num episodes to 20, which means that the policy will be tested on 20 episodes. I think from the next RLlib version, this key is going to be renamed to evaluation duration, so keep that in mind. And for those of you who have a GPU-enabled TensorFlow, you should use numGPUs to 1. You should set that to 1 in order to use your GPU. But I'm not going to use my GPU here, so it's not needed in this problem. So I will just use 0 here. Let's run this. Actually, before I run this, I need to stop the previous experiment. Yeah. So as you can see, running an experiment produces a lot of output. So let's learn how to read that. The most important information is found in these tables that you see here. The iter column tells you the training iteration number. So this is the summary of the first training iteration. This is the summary of the second training iteration, and so on. This TS indicates how many environment steps the agent was trained on so far. And if we see the first training iteration, we see that 4,000 time steps were executed in the environment, and the second training iteration shows 8,000. So this means every training iteration involves the agent taking 4,000 steps in the environment. The reward column tells us the average total reward per episode obtained by the agent, and this is typically smoothed over a certain number of episodes, which is set to 100 by default. So this is the average of the last 100 training episodes. This value should increase as the training progresses, which you can see here. Like the first training iteration was 22. Now it's in the second one, it's 43, then 66, then 96, and so on. And this is a very good indication that the agent is successfully learning in the environment. To evaluate the agent's current performance, we should look at the evaluation data. The evaluation data can be found after every 2 training iterations in the evaluation key. So let's try to find the evaluation key. And here it is, the evaluation key. And the episode reward mean inside the evaluation key is the indicator of the agent's current performance. So this means the agent is getting, on an average, 365 cumulative rewards per episode. So if we let the algorithm run for a while, which we have done now, we will see that the total reward per episode reaches nearly 500. Has it already reached 500? Let's see. So almost near 500, which was the goal in cartpole V1. Therefore, the agent has already learned to solve the cartpole V1 problem.